Look, that young dynamic lad is just about to realize that he needs an FX paddleboard.
There are just too many.
So he went to the hardware store, got in trouble for filming without permission, and returned with nicely cut wood.
See description for sizes.
We'll also use some other goodies, but not yet, so ksh ksh. First I drill some holes where the cable jacks shall be mounted. I want to screw the jacks into these metal plates I picked up at the hardware store, so I'm cutting them in half with an angle grinder. Now we can drill some smaller holes and test fit the metal plates. Looks good so far, so we can start to glamp. Because first I glue, and then I clamp, without a clue, but like a champ. Maybe I should stop building things and start a poetry channel instead. Same approach for the second board. I really thought that I'd invented a new word here, but then I learned that I'm just misusing the common term for glamorous camping. While the glue dries, you can optionally shave, have a tree crash in your place, remove it, go to Norway, shower in a waterfall, and return. It's not necessary, but that's how I did it. The next step on the list is sanding. Then painting. And for a nice finish, I recommend the second layer. For the next step, we need some fluffy fabric or carpet that Velcro will stick to.
It's so cool.
We attach it to the board with a stapler. First the shorter sides and then the longer ones. A plank serves as a guide for the staple gun and also for cutting the fabric. The stretchier it is, the more staples you will like to use for fixing it. Using a black marker on those blank staples makes them a bit less prominent. When both boards are prepared, it's time to proceed with the cable jacks. We can do some soldering now to get a cool feature for our board. By attaching half patch cables to the jacks, we make cables that can permanently stay connected to the effects pedals. So when you set up your gear at a concert, you directly connect the board to your ambient guitar, and you're done. It's also easy to patch several boards together that way, so if you have big plans, this is the board you want. Now let's finish the soldering quickly. When I attached the first jack, I realized those corners would collect a lot of dust after a while. My immediate reaction was maybe a bit emotional, but then I had an idea. Those dust caps will keep the cable jacks nice and clean, and also protect the soldering joints from breaking. Next, me attaches the ledges. Now we just need to stick some Velcro tape under our pedals and put them on the board. Finally, time to open the treasure chest. I think the best thing about a big pedal board is that it's the perfect excuse to build more DIY effects pedals. At the moment I still have 5 kits lying around that wait for assembly, but more about that in my future videos, though I might like to document how I design and build an electric guitar first. Anyway, for now there is still one important step to perform. Use Slabber Spice. I promise you will not regret it. Thank you for watching.